But we just want to quickly also hear from Anupama Kapur, clinical psychologist, who also authored Dove's beauty test report, and Dr. Maitri Chand, family therapist and clinical assistant professor at the Mercer University School of Medicine in the US. Anupama Kapur, you've had conversations with young women and you've authored the Dove beauty test report. The numbers are quite startling, and they point to just how entrenched these narrow ideas of beauty are. What was your experience of putting together this report like, and were you surprised by what you found out?
Yes, it was heart-wrenching, no doubt about it. The experiences I've had in talking with young women, I mean actually women of all ages for that matter, when it comes to how their looks or their body image or you know the kind of hair they have or the kind of eyes that they have affects their self-concept and sense of self-worth is tremendous. As we know, India has one of the largest populations, so it's known for the highest number of highest percentage of depression in the whole world, especially amongst women. Okay, and I must say that a significant contributing factor to that is our sense of self-worth, which is comprised of the way that we look at ourselves physically as well, and especially with regard to the body image. So as I said, yes, the research has been overwhelming, and this is something I've seen across the board. Yeah. Why was I surprised by it? No, not at all. Having had many experiences, being a female myself, and having had experiences which reinforce these beauty stereotypes right from childhood, it was definitely not surprising that the current findings that we did have reinforce what we've always known in a way.
If I can come back to you, Dr. Anupama Kapur, congratulations on doing this study. It's just so important. I'm really surprised it wasn't done earlier. And as you say, we all knew about it, but what this study shows is the extreme level of pressure on young girls and women. I just wanted to go one step further and ask you, because you're a medical person and you study this in depth, can this blow to a woman's self-esteem be so damaging that it results in depression and even more serious and chronic mental health issues?
It's very, very large contributor to depression amongst women, and even at times leads to suicide. For that matter, right from the time the child is in fact in the womb, a mother is told don't have tea because the color of the child will be dark. If the child is born dark, in fact, the mother is counseled to use various kind of beauty remedies to lighten the color. So it's, and this continues throughout life. And it affects not only our own self-image, but the career choices that we make, the careers or, the kind of life partner we choose for that matter. And it also leads to very, very serious feelings of loneliness and isolation, because it impacts our ability to develop, our social skills. Because people with poor self-concepts generally retreat or, start isolating themselves because they are not comfortable in general society. They feel inferior to the other people out there. And therefore, what also accompanies this kind of mental, frame of mind is that, it leads to increasing loneliness and isolation. And in fact, that seems to be the next pandemic that we are expecting in India.